We pray in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Good
morning. And welcome again to our Eucharist on this sixth Sunday of Easter. We give thanks to our God for the many, many blessings that we have received during this past week. For our failures and our weaknesses, we ask for the forgiveness of our God. Lord Jesus, you came that we may have life and have it to the full. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are the light of the world. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You came that we may reconcile to you and reconcile to one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may our loving God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to life everlasting. Amen. Glory to God in the highest.
And let peace be with your Lord, we pray. We bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, the God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, the begotten Son, Lord God and the Lord, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, and save us. You take away the sins of the world,
God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to it of what we do. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Philip went to a Samaritan town and proclaimed the Christ to them. The people united in welcoming the message Philip preached, either because they had heard of the miracles he worked or because they saw them for themselves. There were, for example, unclean spirits that came shrieking out of many who were possessed, and several paralytics and the cripples were cured. As a result, there was great rejoicing in that town. When the apostles in Jerusalem heard that Samaria had accepted the word of God, they sent Peter and John to them, and they went down there and prayed for the Samaritans to receive the Holy Spirit, for as yet he had not come down on any of them. They had only been baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then they laid hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out with God to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Cry out with joy to God, all the earth. O sing to the glory of his name. O render him glorious praise. Say to God, how tremendous your deeds.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Before you all the earth shall bow, shall sing to your name. Come and see the works of God, tremendous his deeds among men. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. He turned the sea into dry land. They passed through the river dry shod. Let our joy then be in him. He rules forever by his might. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Come and hear all who fear God. I will tell what he did for my soul. Blessed be God who did not reject my prayer, nor withhold his love from me. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Reverence the Lord Christ in your hearts and always have your answer ready for people who ask you the reason for the hope that you all have. But give it with courtesy and respect and with a clear conscience, so that those who slander you when you are living a good life in Christ may be proved wrong in the accusations that they bring. And if it is the will of God that you should suffer, it is better to suffer for doing right than for doing wrong. Why? Christ himself, innocent though he was, had died once for sins, died for the guilty, to lead us to God. In the body he was put to death, in the spirit he was raised to life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. I shall ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever, the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive, since it neither sees nor knows him. But you know him, because he is with you. He is in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come back to you. In a short time, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, because I live and you will live. On that day, you will understand that I am in the Father, and you in me, and I in you. Anybody who receives my commandments and keeps them will be one who loves me, and anybody who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I shall love him and show myself to him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You can see Father Kevin celebrating the Mass last Sunday here in this place. And what remains with me from his sharing, breaking of the word last Sunday up to this moment, Kevin sharing about the encounter of Jesus and Thomas. As Jesus was saying, "I'm going away to prepare a place, and I'll come back and take you so that you will be with me. And you know the way where I'm going." And I was thinking, is this Mary Street? Gladesville Road? The way, see? And then Thomas, "Sorry, Jesus. we don't know the way." And I like what Kevin said last Sunday, "Look here, mate, we've been together, me and you, I am the way, you have seen me, the way I do things, that is the way." So it seems complicated, but it's not. "You have seen me, the way I do things, that is the way. The life, you've seen what life I live, that's the life. And the truth that I speak, that is So I'm the way, the truth, and the life. As I said, and I said it to Gavin during the week, deadline stays with me, even though we have our daily readings and meditation. So the readings of today is a continuation from last week, from the chapter 14 of John. In the context of our readings, this is the end of the washing of the feet, of the Last Supper. And Jesus is saying his farewell speech, message to his disciples. Quite a few of them. So we had one last week, the one Jesus saying, I'm going away and prepare a place for you. So this time, reading through the gospel, there's something of the divine love. Eternal presence and spiritual life. What does it mean? So the divine love was our gospel acclamation, the first line of the gospel of today. So Jesus is saying, if you love me, keep my word, keep my commandment. And I will come and live in you. Not only I, the Father and I, we will come and make our home in you. It reminds me of after the resurrection, when Jesus, his encounter with Peter. Peter, you love me?
Yes.
Feed my sheep. Second time, Peter. Peter was getting not very happy. Even the third time. So I think that's the other way. So Jesus could have said to the apostle, do you love me? Yes, keep my word. Keep my commandments. Remember the time Jesus was talking with his, he was in the house and Mary and relatives arrived. So Mary said to someone, go and tell Jesus, my son, I'm here, want to talk to him, speak to him. So he went in, and Jesus, what? Mom outside wanting to talk to you. And Jesus said, clear, crystal clear, my mom, my dad, my brothers and sisters, they are the one who hear the word, my word, and keep. Eternal presence. So Jesus is talking about, like, not only myself will come to you, but the Father as well. And then the Trinity. So that's the three. The eternal presence, not only Jesus, the Father, and the Spirit will come. And be with them, as he said, I won't leave you scattered, orphans. No. Yeah. Jesus, after his death, rising from the dead, sharing in the privilege of the Father, and yet he still wants to come back and be with the apostles and us. So that is the spiritual home. And I think it becomes very clear to us when we come to November 1, All Saints, or All Souls, although some of our parents have gone, or grandparents have gone, but somehow we can still talk to them. And furthermore, the saints, they are still living within us. We hear also some of the sports, and some, maybe you know what I'm. Some they call their field is the spiritual home. I think the champion, it's a physical game, maybe it's a mental game, but they call their ground a spiritual home because they are calling the unknown, the spirit. So that is what is Jesus is saying, our champion, our God, to be with us. So that's what he was saying to the apostles. Now I'm going, but the Spirit will be there to support, to guide, and to lead you in the mission that I've started. Beautiful reading, our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles. So we hear of Philip the evangelist, or Philip the deacon, different from Philip the apostles. Remember the story, there was a bit of a commotion, the Hellenists, they were not there, widows were missing out on distribution of food, so they complained. So that's when the apostles had a little meeting and decided to choose 7 people full of the Holy Spirit and wisdom to help them in the mission. So Stephen and Philip were outstanding in the election. So Philip, his mission was to go to the enemy, to the Samaritans. Yeah, we know the story very well. Spread the good news and the good news of reconciliation. And the apostles heard about the good news. Second reading from Peter. If we ask at this time, after the resurrection, what could be a practical expression of this time? So Paul offers something. And very clear. Paul is saying reverence to Christ. And if you have that, you will be a blessing to the people that you live with. A blessing. Next Sunday we will celebrate the Feast of the Ascension, but the Advent day is Thursday, the 40th day from the resurrection. And then Jesus said, you wait and you pray for the Advocate, for the Paraclete, for the Holy Spirit. So that's the first novena. 9 days. So like what we are going through at this time, the pandemic, panic. We start already to see the light at the end of the tunnel, that we pray during our novena and waiting to celebrate the Feast of Pentecost. We now acknowledge our faith. I believe in one God, Father, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, our Father Almighty. And there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, this time we offer up our prayers of thanksgiving, and we also ask our petition from our loving God. We pray for Pope Francis, church leaders, for the wisdom and knowledge they need at this time in our walk of life and in our faith. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray also for leaders of countries, as we again in this pandemic, virus disease, for what is for the common good and well-being of our world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Any prayer that you might like to offer up?
Pray for our parishioner Rhonda Boyd, who passed away this week at the age of 93. Thank God for the mighty contribution that she and her husband Arthur made to the life of our parish. May she now rest in peace and may her family be comforted.
We pray with Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace,
the Lord is with you.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Sisters, that our sacrifice, the bread and the wine, will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that, purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. At all times we acclaim you, O Lord, and in this time of our woe, you Lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, our universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with passable joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. his gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, and again giving him thanks and praise, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Anthony, our Bishop, and for those who minister to your word. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, and all your saints, we please you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Himself taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in all days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. The power and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of Jesus be with you all.
Yes.
We offer each other that sign of peace.
Thank you.
takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, say our parish prayer. Loving God,
you have guided us in your sons. We find our way as families and individuals in you.
Lord Jesus, encouraged by the breath of your Spirit, we thank you for all the blessings. Before our final prayer, with Father Kevin leading us in our music of the day, Kia and Nick, and our young members of our choir, those who are doing the readings, so thank you for our mass of the day, and our love from all of us coming out to you, our parishioners, and wherever you are joining us in our Eucharist of today, that you may have our good week. Thank you. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, you restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ. Increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Yes.
May our loving God bless us, the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our mass has been offered. We go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.